Hi, Greg. August saw some market volatility. We now know that that's all because of a yen carry trade, but let's talk about where markets go from here based on the recent data coming out of the US.
Yeah, August never disappoints. August is always a volatile month, and I think it came on with spades this year to start. And I think the yen carry trade was definitely the trigger at the end, but I think there were a lot of things that built up to this. Like we had the week prior to that, a weaker US payroll number, which started to increase the odds of a recession, started to get some more concern. Just is the US economy really starting to slow down faster? And with the Fed not cutting in July, there's a bit of a fear that the Fed is kind of behind the curve. And it's kind of got one of these things that the market got a little more disappointed with what the Fed was doing. Adding to that, we had some weaker earnings from some of the tech bellwethers that really had led the market higher. And I think when you head into a low volume August, I think that's where the trigger was with the carry trade unwinding and causing some volatility. Now, we've seen a pretty good snapback in the last few trading sessions past that. And now the question is, okay, now what? And I still have to think you have to go back to history that the August, September, October period is the most volatile time of the year. And we're only in the middle of August, so I wouldn't expect things to calm down completely over the next few weeks.
Let's just unpack some of what you had touched on. JP Morgan pricing at a 30% chance of a recession. What are your thoughts? What are we looking at?
Well, I think that's the big debate, and some other banks are up there with higher odds of recession in the U.S. And this is really what everyone's going to be focusing on for next year. It's probably going to be rare to see the recession ahead of the U.S. presidential election, but we came into this year looking for a recession. I think it's been pushed back farther than some had expected, but certainly there are some signs of slowing out there. The global economy is not as strong as it had been, so I think there's definitely a risk that the U.S. consumer is starting to pull back. We've definitely seen the Canadian consumer pull back a little more. So recession odds, I think, are going to creep up a little higher. And then certainly when you look at the bond market, we've had a big pullback in yields, and the bond market's pricing in almost 200 basis points of cuts over the next 12 months. And if the bond market's going to be cutting 200 basis points, they got to be worried about a recession more than anything else.
Let's talk about market expectations going forward. You had mentioned that the US might see 200 basis point interest rate cuts over the course of 12 months by the Federal Reserve. Let's just bring in a few more elements into that conversation. We are done with Q2 earnings. We saw that tech was the dominant trade so far this year. Where do markets go from here?
Well, I think what we're starting to see is a bit of rotation away from that leadership. Magnificent Seven and tech were the big themes to start the year. The AI theme has been dominant for sure. We're starting to see a bit of cracks in that narrative. And in the last few quarters, the last quarterly reports we saw, there's a little bit of a pushback on the big hyperscalers and the tech companies of, is this CapEx spend on semis worth it? And are they getting the return on investment for it? So there's a bit of a crack in that narrative. NVIDIA is going to report near the end of August, and that'll be interesting to see just what they're doing. And there's a lot of concerns about a delay in their next set of chips. So I think what we're going to look at is as we start to see more expectations of rate cuts, the Fed starting that rate cutting cycle in September, we could see this big rotation away from technology to the other sectors, which really haven't caught that much of attention. So we caught a bit of that in July, where we had the big spike in small caps and the Russell 2000. And I would expect in the second half of the year, we're going to see more of that as these tech stocks start to move to the background, and maybe some of these other sectors like the cyclicals and the financials start to move forward.
In this volatile environment, where do you think investors should go to seek any kind of protection?
Well, one area we've been looking at is in real assets, and we've been talking about this for a bit. If you head into a concern with the US dollar potentially starting to lose some of its status as the king dollar currency, we might see some weakness in the dollar. And what that's really good for is the commodities and gold in particular. So gold has been a standout in the last little bit and starting to show investors why they even look at this. And I do think heading into the second half of the year, these real assets are still going to be a place that you can allocate towards as a nice way to protect against some volatility in the market. If we do get some more geopolitical risks start to spike up, the U.S. election is certainly going to be something to watch. And then with that, if the U.S. dollar starts to pull back, gold and real assets could be a nice diversifier in portfolios.
Let's bring it here to Canada. And what should investors be focusing on here?
Well, the big thing with Canada, of course, is just the health of the Canadian consumer. There's been a lot of concern about this mortgage reset, which is really supposed to kick in next in 2025. And we're starting to see just more stress in the system. So the Bank of Canada has already embarked on rate cuts, and we're starting to get more confident that they're going to be more aggressive in cutting into the fall as well. And really, when we get to the banks reporting at the end of August, it's all going to be about listening for signs of how the housing market's holding up, how the consumer holding up, what are defaults looking like, and I think that's going to be the big focus for Canada, to see if the Canadian consumer is doing better than feared, because there's a lot of fear out there that the Canadian consumers definitely got some under some stress.